NewGenGamers.com.
Retro!
Today on Ray's Retro Reviews, we are doing one more N64 title here, and it's Star Wars Shadows of the Empire. This was a very ambitious game that Nintendo made a deal with LucasArts to do, and it was supposed to be an offshoot of the original trilogy. It was in between episodes, I believe, 5 and 6, if I know my Star Wars lore well enough. Either 4 and 5 or 5 and 6. I think it was 4 and 5, actually. It'll say. But Shadows of the Empire was supposed to actually be a piece of, like, Star Wars lore. And Nintendo worked out a deal so they could do the exclusive game for Shadows of the Empire. And what we got, unfortunately, was a kind of a half-cooked title. Whereas some of the elements fell together really well, and some of them just fell kind of blank. So here's the opening for Shadows of the Empire. Now, something that Nintendo also wanted to do with their GameCube launch is the same thing. Is they wanted to have an exclusive Star Wars game with the launch of the console. And the one for GameCube was a lot better than Shadows of the Empire. It was Rogue Squadron 2. And I remember when I first got my GameCube that the thing that I saw that convinced me to buy the GameCube was the Death Star Run demo that they had for it. And it looked just like the, you know, the Death Star run in A New Hope. So it had me sold right there. So we'll start here. Yes, if you put in Wampa Stompa, you have everything unlocked. Just a little secret there. So, we can go all the way to the end. Or we can go all the way to the beginning. Skyhook battle is the end. Zizer's palace. So we'll just go up and start the game at the Battle of Hoth. Which would put the game between 5 and 6. Alright, you are going to be flying a speeder just like Luke Skywalker. Now, the N64 controller really lends itself to this. Because you couldn't do this on other systems at the time. Because when this came out in 96, the PlayStation had yet to release their DualShock. So full analog control like this was unheard of. Oh, don't want to shoot the Rebel Tower. I want to avoid that. There's the Ions. Now, any moment here, there should be walkers coming onto the screen. We'll just shoot down the probe droids, try to avoid getting shot ourselves here. And this is on the original N64 hardware, so after a couple years, the analog stick has given away a little bit, so it's not as accurate as I had hoped. Hey, I'm on your side. Get that last probe droid. Annoying little bugger. Just do one of these deals. He's like right in front of me. So we're gonna have to take a wide turn. Come back at him from another angle. Well, I guess that's one way to do it. Stage complete. Now that's just the first part. Now the AT-STs come into play. What you want to do with them is start shooting at them from a distance and just kind of inch away at their health by shooting at their heads. Now I'm almost shot down here because I'm taking a lot of Imperial fire here. Here's that same AT-ST that I've been battling. Oh, I gotta avoid that fire. There's the bridge. Now this is the first person mode, where you're actually inside the cockpit. And there goes that AT. There goes the probe droid. Now, that wasn't wise, but I got a lot of damage on him. Like, you'll take a lot of damage flying directly into fire like that. But, now if I hit my brakes, I might be able to destroy him beforehand. But, even though I destroyed him, you still crash into him and take damage. And since I had destroyed all the AT-STs, then I'm good there. Now we get to go take down the AT-ATs. Yeah. I'm gonna get the AT-STs out of the way. Now. I'm gonna switch back out of cockpit view. Like I said, once again, I'm taking more heavy fire. But in a last resort, when you're down to like one sliver of life, go ahead and crash into an AT-ST. You lose a life, but that's one AT-ST down. Yeah, I just have to get close enough to fire my tow cable. So I want to hit the brakes, make a turn, get close enough. Okay, now my tow cable's attached, but he flew away. So you have to make sure you got your tow cable close enough, and then the next part is navigating around him. Apparently it's been so long since I played this that I've forgotten the control for that. Just hold the brakes and turn. Alright, well, since that's not working too well for me, I'm gonna call it a day here. And we'll say that was Star Wars Shadows of the Empire. Hope you enjoyed, and happy arcading, everybody.
NewGenGamers.com.